Say hello to my subscribers right there.
We part of the company. We part of that guy right there. It's the best mechanic there.
Yeah, now he's an influencer in YouTube.
No, serious. That's one of the best mechanics.
Okay, what's up, guys? This is another Holmes Law video. My name is Mel. If this is your first time, I'm going to be showing you how to bend 4-inch EMT on this 881 mobile Camtrack. Okay, I have a video here that I'm going to do a voice over only because the site was really noisy. So I'm going to go ahead and play this video for you, and I'm just going to be going through the details on how to bend an offset. So let's go ahead and start it. Now, after you're done, obviously you want to lay out your conduit, okay, with the spacing of whatever you need, okay. And once you're done laying it out, you place your pipe inside the bender like so, and you want to lock it up or snug it up, what like I just did right now, okay, making sure that this is, you know, level. This bender was a little messed up, so sometimes the hydraulic pump releases it, but you want to make sure that you level it out and lock it up, okay, and then place your level on there, your no dog, okay, so that this is all snugged up, the follow bar and the saddle and the shoe is all snugged up together. Now see, I hear and notice that it's not, it went down. If you follow the arrow, you'll see what I'm talking about. It went down. So now I level that out again. I zero out my digital level and I check my no dog. And then I commence to bend. Now for me, I'm doing a small offset, very small. So I didn't lock up the chain on the back because the amount of bend that I'm making wasn't going to make a difference. It was only going to be a 4-inch offset, so I'm only bending it to 12 degrees. It's 10 degree bends, but I had to take it 2 degrees over for spring back, maybe a little less, but 12 worked for me. So after that, I released the lever, okay, to release the shoe. As you can see, everything came apart. I take off my saddle, and basically that's it. I move it up to my next mark. Okay, for you want to always place the chain. If it's a big bend, don't forget to place the chain back here. For me, it didn't matter. I was in a little rush. I should have done it, but it was a small bend, 10 degrees, didn't really make a difference. It wasn't going to pull up the pipe too much. Now, I don't know if you noticed my pencil marks, but they're really light. What I use to go around the whole conduit, I usually use the steam pipe fitter's wrap. You can use a small one, doesn't really matter, it does the job. It gives you some nice square marks around the whole pipe. I like to use that. It actually makes, that's how I was taught, so that's what I use. But you can wrap, you can use anything. You can use your tape measure or whatever the case may be, just to give you a square mark. Here I'm moving it up to the saddle, the beginning of the saddle, my next mark. And once I get it there, I lock it up and I start to bend again. Now it's important that once you're done getting it at your mark and you level it out, or whatever you call it on the field, you know, snugging it up, some guys call it snug up, you know, locking it down, leveling it out. After you're done doing that, you know, you want to make sure that you level this out before you lock it up. On the second time, you have to do that before you lock it up. The first time you want to lock it up and then place the no dog so you could, you know, have it level. Once you put on that no dog the first time, you do not want to remove it, okay? Do not remove that level. Now I'm taking it to 12 degrees again for a 10 degree bend. Okay, after we're done with this, that's it, your offset is complete. I'm bending short offsets, so I'm just using one pipe. I'm gonna bend two offsets on one pipe and I'm gonna end up cutting it because I only needed a 50 inch length of pipe with a 3-inch offset on it. So I'm using one pipe, I'm bending two offsets on a pipe. I needed four of them, so I'm bending two of them. Okay. Now, one thing I wanted to actually express to you was that when you get a perfect bend to the degree that you want it at, whether it be 10, 15, 30 degrees, you know, I recommend that you look up. There's a ram ruler up by the ram. You'll notice it. It has, it's like a ruler. Check out the measurement once you have a perfect degree bend, okay? And write that measurement down. If there's ever a time, you know, put it on your phone or whatever the case may be, because if you ever had a moment where you don't have a protractor or a digital level or wherever the case may be, you can take it to the measurement on the ram ruler and it'll give you a spot on bend. You know, my opinion is it gives you more accurate bends than, I mean, it's not going to give you a more accurate bend than a digital level, but it's definitely better than the protractor. Okay. So, and even with the digital level, some guys, you know, they'll get confused, they won't zero it out, you know, you'll get some bad bends. But with the ruler, you'll always be right. Once you know the exact measurement of the degree that you want, and you record it, you'll never go wrong. So up there is the ram ruler. Don't forget what I'm saying. Once you get a good bend, always check the ruler and see what the measurement is, and that's it. You're good to go. Write it down. Now, here we're going over the process again. Okay, I'm going to show you all four bends because I want you to actually get it down pat and see how I do the offsets. It's fairly easy. Once you know how to do the calculation, using this machine is very easy. Okay, the machine does all the work for you and the digital level tells you when to stop. Okay, or the ram ruler, either or. Okay, now you see how I have my pipe very close up. You don't want to go any less than 4 inches. Okay, if you do, you'll never get the connector or the coupling on because it's gonna actually make it a little oval. So you see how I got my no dog, I'm putting it on, it's already locked up. Now I put on my no dog, my level. On the second bend, you want to make sure it's straight and then level it out. Okay, but this is the first bend. So now I'm taking it to a 12 degree again, 2 degrees over a 10, because I want a 10 degree bend, so I'm taking it 2 degrees over. Anything under 30 degrees, you want to do 2 degrees extra for spring back. And anything over that, like 45, 60, 90s, you want to go 3 degrees, but that's anything over 30, okay? I usually do 3 degrees for the spring back. Now I'm done with that, and I'm going to go to the second bend, okay? Don't forget to always chain it up. On the hydraulic pump, you're going to have the lever. Okay, when you're ready to bend or lock up the pipe, you have to put the lever down. And when you want to release it, you push the lever up. Here, I have my mark. It's very light. You can barely see it, but I do have my pencil mark there. And I go ahead and put my saddle on. Usually you want to get somebody to help you. I've been doing this a long time, so I don't really have to get somebody to help me. I already know how to work it. But most of the time you want to get somebody to help you. You get worn out after a while. I check my level. I grab my remote. I make sure it's level. And now I'm just holding the saddle in because sometimes it'll move forward. You want to hold that in. Be careful not to pinch your hands. Level it out. Now that it's level, I'm going to check my no dog. It's good. If it's not, you release the lever and try it again. After you put your digital level on, you zero it out. That's very important. If you don't zero it out, then you're going to have to add the difference, okay? Just like you would a protractor. The protractor, you can't zero it out. So what you do is, if it's 2 degrees, you know, not level, what you want to do, instead of taking it, if you're doing a 90, instead of taking it to 93 because of the 3 degree spring back, you'll take it to 95. Okay, depending on what the protractor is telling you. If it's not on zero, you know, whether it's less or plus or minus, that's what you want to add or subtract from whatever degrees you're doing. I released it. I already finished my offset. Okay. By the way, I was doing doing a 4-inch offset at 10 degrees. My spacing was 23 inches in between bends, basically. So that was it. I had a guy walk by and ask me if I was doing a 4-point saddle. It looked pretty cool. I could have passed it off as a 4-point saddle, but nah, I just didn't want to waste the pipe, so I just did 2 offsets on one pipe, and I ended up cutting it at 50 inches on both sides, and that was it, because I only lost about a half an inch of for shrink, so I didn't really lose anything. Here I'm placing the pin through the saddle. And that's pretty much it. The digital level, it's pretty good. You know, you should, if you don't have one, you should get one, because it's really accurate. I mean, it gives you, you know, fractions of an inch of a degree. You know, you can get in between, you know, degrees of bends, especially when you're doing a 22.5 degree bend, that half degree, you know, it gives you that half degree. It shows you when you're at the half point. It's pretty good. But the RAM ruler, I suggest you get a little notebook together on all the benders that you use, you know, and all the RAM measurements for the bender. It's the best method. You know, I have them all written down on my phone. If I happen to forget my digital level, I just go into my phone and I need a 45, and I look up the measurement and I take it straight to the measurement, and it's always spot on. Now, you always want to remember, when you use the RAM ruler, check exactly where it is that it stops at. You know, sometimes, because it only has 1/8 inch markings. So sometimes it's in between, you know, the 1/8 inch. You want to write that down, you know? You want to make sure that you remember that. Because it does make a difference. Okay? Also, if you don't have a no-dog, another way to do it is you can put a Kindorf strap with a piece of Kindorf under it or above it. You're going to actually put the Kindorf above it with the Kindorf strap underneath it, clamping it on, and you can put a level on top of that. It works the same way. Most of the time, when I'm using the Cyclone, that's what I use, you know, because you can actually sight down the pipe and see if it's actually level. You don't have to walk all the way to the front of it. With the no dog, you have to actually walk up to the front of it and check it. You want to make sure that your mark is lined up with the front edge of the saddle, okay? And if for some reason when you go to lock it up or level it out, if it's not level on your no dog or you missed your mark a little bit, release it and do it again. You know, you want to try to get that mark perfectly in front of the saddle. After a while, you'll know exactly how to get that mark spot on, you know? Put the digital level on, zero it out, and you're good to go. Okay, so here I wanted to show you where the RAM ruler is. It's basically right on the other side of here, of this pipe here. Okay, just wanted to show you that. And also, this is what I use to make my square marks around my conduit. Okay, it's a regular pipe wrap. It's what the steam fitters use, you know, for anything like 3 and 4 inch. This is what I like to use. When you're up to like 5 and 6 inch, this helps too. Okay, so basically that's pretty much it. I appreciate you guys watching to the end of the video. Please post your work on the hashtags, you know, conduitologist, conduitology, you know, Holmes Law, Also, you know, follow me on Facebook at Holmes Law, Instagram at Holmes Law. Also, I'm on TikTok. Really appreciate all you guys, all the subscribers, you know, share it, you know, tell your friends about it. Any video requests, just, you know, hit me up and send me a message. I really appreciate it. And thanks. This is Holmes Law, Mel. I'm out.